Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, DwyerSportsBetting.com. Look us up in the sports section on Roku, Dwyer Boxing, and Sports News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. A YouTube viewer, Terrell, and I thank you publicly, has tipped me off to the fact that on BoxRec.com today, September 28th, 2013, they have actually listed Amir Khan's next fight as taking place on May the 3rd, 2013, against Floyd Mayweather. Right? Now, let me just say, if it's true, and this news is not on any of the other sites that I've looked at, right? This is just BoxRec.com. But understand, BoxRec.com, in my opinion, is really the authoritative source for scheduled fights and boxers' records, right? BoxRec often has information the rest of the public doesn't have. And it does appear that the contracts for the Amir Khan-Devin Alexander matchup haven't been signed. So Khan might in fact be free to fight Floyd Mayweather. And Mayweather, of course, wants to fight very high-profile, credible opponents. Right? Mayweather's been fighting a lot of talented individuals. And in my opinion, Amir Khan is a very talented individual. I'm excited by this fight. In fact, I'm excited more, perhaps, than most, because I firmly believe that if you're going to beat Floyd Mayweather, in fact, if you're even going to be competitive with Floyd Mayweather, you need to have hand speed. That's really a requirement. And this is one of the few fights, Amir Khan against Floyd Mayweather, where, in my opinion, Floyd's opponent, Amir Khan, would have the faster hand speed than the all-time great. Right? Khan, quite frankly, mixes hand speed with length and foot speed. And if he comes out and if he has a game plan and if he fights the right fight using an excellent jab, timing, foot speed and distance, right, mixed in with power that's underrated, right, Amir Khan has a punch, then in my opinion, this fight could be a great fight if it happens. In fact, before the Saul Alvarez fight, and I believe the week leading up to the fight, I actually made a video where I talked about the fact that Mayweather would have a problem against the style that Amir Khan had in the first two rounds of Khan's loss to Danny Garcia, right? Let me also take this opportunity, because it really does, merit mentioning, that there's a great article on ESPN. It was written on September 19th, right after the destruction of Saul Alvarez by Floyd Mayweather. It's written by an author for ESPNDeportes.com, Salvador Rodriguez, where he actually interviewed a legendary trainer, a guy I follow, Nacho Beristain. And Beristain talked about the mistakes made by Saul Alvarez against Floyd Mayweather. Right, so here you have really one of boxing's most knowledgeable guys giving his take on the mistakes that Saul Alvarez, a previously unbeaten Mayweather opponent, made in getting really dominated by Floyd Mayweather. But let's be clear here. I know there's a lot of post-fight spin. I know one judge had the fight a draw. I can tell you that as I watched the fight, I thought Mayweather, at a minimum, won the first six rounds of the fight. And I'm not alone. Dan Rayfield scoring the fight live. In other words, this is contemporaneous reporting. Had Floyd Mayweather winning the first six rounds of the fight. Right? The second half of the fight, I mean, I thought really Mayweather controlled it. You know, Saul Alvarez had some moments, but I think most people watching the fight would be very hard-pressed to realistically give Saul Alvarez more than, let's say, three rounds. And keep in mind, at no time is Mayweather overpowered. The result of the fight was really a foregone conclusion by the end of the sixth round, because it was clear that Mayweather had dominated, that Mayweather had the hand speed advantage, the defensive brilliance, the mental advantage, right? Mayweather looked like he just knew more than Saul Alvarez about the sport of boxing. Well, Nacho Beristain broke down the fight. And according to this excellent article on ESPN, dated September the 19th, by Salvador Rodriguez, Beristain focused on five areas where he thought that Saul Alvarez came up short. The first was that Alvarez entered the ring with no clear strategy on how to beat Floyd Mayweather. Right? In this section, and I'm just going to read Beristain's quote. Beristain says, "When Mayweather came out of the corner to attack rather than wait on the punches, that was when Alvarez's strategy ended, and there was no definite plan. Canelo was quickly frustrated, and from the time when Mayweather's punches came at him right on target, he already didn't know what to do. Mayweather broke the attack strategy with his combination of left-right hooks, and Alvarez couldn't adapt." Right? The best section. Well, the other problems Beristain saw was that Alvarez had a lack of defense, that Alvarez had no control in his corner, that Alvarez failed to take risks, and that Alvarez, simply put, was not prepared for Mayweather. In fact, let me read that paragraph because I believe it's the best quote I've come across on the fight. He says, "If the opponent that you face is not like you've been told, and it turns out you don't compete in defense, that you don't compete in speed, that you don't compete in effectiveness, they didn't tell you the truth." Given that Alvarez's corner created false hopes that gave us this result, this is not about hitting the gloves and guard. This is about seeing each factor that can change the fight for you. Now let's talk about Amir Khan. Let me just say this. Amir Khan, and I'll agree with this, cannot compete. In fact, I would argue, really, no one can compete with Floyd Mayweather defensively. The best part of Mayweather's game, other than his knowledge of the sport, and I think the secret to Floyd Mayweather is his mental understanding of the sport. I believe everything else flows from Floyd's mental approach, right? Floyd is just mentally tough. Floyd has made a mental commitment to the sport of boxing. Apart from Floyd's mental edge, I believe the best part of Floyd's game is Floyd's defense. Even before you get to hand speed and stuff like that, understand that Floyd defensively is brilliant. You know, I've come across other YouTube commentators who place Floyd in the ring with people like Ray Robinson and a lot of other all-time greats. Just understand, there is simply no comparison, none, between Floyd Mayweather and Sugar Ray Robinson defensively. Mayweather is much better than Ray Robinson. In fact, I encourage people to look at the Ray Robinson film against Rocky Graziano. What you're going to see in that film, and it's a brilliant third round knockout or something like that by Ray Robinson, is you're going to see there's a moment in that fight where Rocky Graziano actually drops Ray Robinson. Right? Robinson took chances, has his hands low. Understand that Floyd Mayweather somehow is able to combine a very high connect ratio. And understand, according to CompuBox, the gap between Mayweather's connect ratio and his opponent's connect ratio is the highest CompuBox has on record over the career of a fighter. Right? Mayweather's able to combine that accuracy with really spectacular defense. So Amir Khan, with his trainer Virgil Hunter, by the way, that's Andre Ward's trainer. So Khan has an elite trainer with him. Could focus on defense from here to the day of the fight, if the fight is actually scheduled, and would not come close to Floyd Mayweather's defense. Understand, too, I'm a skeptic on whether a fighter in his mid to late 20s, can actually learn things like shoulder rolls and tucking the head and rolling with punches. Either you have wired your body that way from your teens when you took up the sport, or you haven't, right? You're not going to learn to do so quickly, automatically, now in your mid to late 20s. In the same manner in which a guy who has approached the sport from day one doing so has the ability to do. Right? And so Amir Khan is going to be defensively deficient. But the point is this. Speed and length can hide a lot of things. Amir Khan has the kind of hand speed. And folks, I'm telling you, it's in the upper 2% of the sport. He has the kind of hand speed, the jab and length, where he can negate a lot of the defense. What he has to do is be busy and operate from the outside. He also has to work on his mental game because he can't be mentally broken like Canelo was out the gate. Right, as I've said in an earlier video, the Canelo fight shocking because Floyd comes out on his front foot. For everyone who claims that Floyd is a runner, I challenge you to look at the first round of the Canelo fight. Floyd's the aggressor in the first round. He comes out on his front foot against a guy with a big punch and a big knockout ratio who's unbeaten. Right? How do you deal with a bully? You come out and you punch him in the mouth. That's what Mayweather does. He comes out, he's on his front foot. The idea is, okay, kid, I hear you can fight. I'm here to fight. What are you going to do? And Canelo folded up like a lawn chair. Right? Floyd on his front foot, and I've said this before, he's a dangerous man. Because the guy has hand speed, and the guy is accurate, and the guy is smart. It's a rough combination for an opponent to deal with. But if you have the hand speed to fire back, if you have the foot speed to back away, if you can make him pay for his aggression, and if you have the ability to back away, you have a chance. I know there are a lot of Amir Khan skeptics out there. Please, look at the film of Khan against Zab Judah. Now, I'll agree, Khan has some terrible highlights. The Danny Garcia highlights are bad, right? Khan keeps hitting the canvas. How do you face Danny Garcia and get hit as flush as Khan gets hit in the third round with Garcia hooks? Don't you know Danny Garcia is a mid-range hooker? You know, how do you fight Lamon Peterson and find yourself bullied up on the ropes? Don't you know Lamon Peterson likes to bully guys over by the ropes? You know, I'll agree, Amir Khan has made some very bad mental mistakes in the ring. No question about it. He's fighting Brutus Prescott, and he's lackadaisical defensively. Don't you know Brutus Prescott has a big punch? So, if Amir Khan can just fight the fight that he did against Zab Judah. Look at that film. Folks, that's a mismatch. If he can fight the fight that he did against Zab Judah, think about it. Judah's hand speed, and Judah has faster hand speed than Floyd, is never a factor in that fight because Khan is using length. Khan is able to deliver shots from way outside and then move. If he can fight that fight and not get mentally frustrated and stay on his game plan. In other words, after the first two rounds against Danny Garcia, he somehow decides he's going to trade with Garcia. Bad decision. If Virgil Hunter can just keep him on the course, tell him, look, those first two rounds against Danny Garcia, let's make those the next 10 rounds in this fight. If he can do that, this is a much more competitive fight. Much more than Floyd Mayweather against Canelo. Y'all know I was on here before that Canelo fight saying Floyd's going to take that fight. Let me just say, with the Amir Khan Mayweather fight, if it happens, that's much higher risk. Right? That requires a look at a much, you know, at a greater amount of film. Right? Understand too, how has Amir Khan been losing fights? Right? Amir Khan really has been losing fights apart from the Lamont Peterson fight that was in Peterson's hometown and that had scoring and point deductions that were a little bit curious. Apart from that fight, Amir Khan has been losing fights by KO. Well, Floyd hasn't been knocking anyone out, right? The Victor Ortiz fight, Victor's looking the other way when he gets hit with the knockout punch, right? Victor's not even paying attention to the fight, right? The Ricky Hatton fight, I'll give you that, but that was a few years ago. Look at the calendar, right? If Floyd doesn't knock out Amir Khan, if Khan goes the distance like Canelo did, like Robert Guerrero did, given his hand speed and volume, isn't this a much closer fight than the Canelo fight? Now, let me say this. Mayweather can fight on his front foot. Mayweather can step forward and punish a guy who doesn't have great head movement. Look at Mayweather against Arturo Gatti. Now, I would argue that's Mayweather at his best, right? But we haven't seen that Mayweather because he hasn't been forced to really trade like that. He was on his front foot against Shane Mosley. Ate a couple of straight right hands, got discouraged, fought a little bit more conservatively after that. Won the fight going away, but stopped pursuing Shane Mosley. He was on his front foot against Saul Alvarez. Alvarez was too clueless to make it a good shootout. If Mayweather goes on his front foot against Amir Khan, folks, there's going to be fireworks. Okay? Because Amir Khan, quite frankly, for all of his problems, he's offensively gifted. I'm sure Floyd thinks he can dent Amir Khan's chin because Amir Khan is viewed as chinny. Let him try. I think this is a good fight. I hope it happens. I'm not making a prediction here other than to say this is a much better fight, if it happens, than Floyd against Saul Alvarez. Let me hear from you. Thanks for stopping by.